Good afternoon and welcome to our show. This is Holy and Heavenly, the Parish Puppet Ministry Program. These young people are 7th and 8th graders and they've been practicing since September. They take their show on the road then beginning in January, but because of COVID, we have a very different kind of year. So we're grateful to have a live audience. These young people have all scripture-based plays. They're professionally written. And if they've been a puppeteer in the past, they have two stripes on one of their sleeves that indicates this is their second year. And if they have a sibling who's been in the ministry, there is a number on that sleeve and a star. And this year, for the first time, we have the fourth child of a family, the Robeck family, who is a puppet minister in puppet ministry. We'd like to especially thank this year Logan Gehring. He purchased our audio sounds that the young people all have when we had to social distance. He helped us come up with a plan to make it happen, so for him, we're very grateful. So without further ado, I offer you Holy and Heavenly.
Hello, everyone. We are Holy and Heavenly, and I hope you enjoy the show. I'm Ivan Cruz.
I'm Sammy Abraham.
I'm Lily Robeck.
I'm Caleb Robeck.
And I'm Grace Poor. We're Heavenly and Holy, and hope you enjoy the show.
My goodness, Stella, what on earth are you doing?
Oh, hi, Lucas. I'm working on the new me.
What's wrong with the old you, may I ask?
Everything, according to the magazine articles I've been reading.
Stella, can you stop for a minute? I'm getting dizzy trying to talk to you.
Sure. Whew, what a workout.
Okay, now, what's all this about a new you?
You know how everyone is so health conscious these days. Every time I pick up a magazine, all I can read about is the importance of a balanced diet, sufficient rest, and exercise. Compared to the models in those magazines, I'm a total wreck.
Oh, you're in such bad shape. Of course, you need to take good care of your body. But I hope you're planning on spending the same amount of time toning up the inside.
The inside?
Yeah, you're spending all this time and effort getting your body in shape. What about your soul?
Oh, my shoes are fine.
No, not your shoes. Your soul. Your inner being. Just as your body needs good food to be healthy, your soul also needs nourishment. Unhealthy TV shows, magazines, music, they all add just to spiritual junk food.
Well then, what would good food be?
For a healthy soul, you need to meditate on God's word. And spend time with Jesus, the bread of life. You also need to go to reconciliation too. That's good spiritual food.
Oh, sure. Next, you're going to tell me my soul needs exercise too, right?
How'd you guess?
But how can I exercise my soul?
Let me ask you a question. What would happen if you sat on the couch and read books about exercising all day long?
Flab City.
But we were reading all about exercising, aren't you?
Sure, but it doesn't do me any good to just read about it. I have to get up off the couch and do it.
Right, and we exercise our souls when we do what the Word says, rather than just read it.
Just knowing what God says isn't enough, is it? We need to be obedient to do all He tells us, huh?
Stella, I think you got it.
Lucas, I see what you're trying to say. I won't neglect the most important part of me, my soul. Say, how about jogging with me back to the house?
Me?
Yes, you. A little exercise wouldn't hurt you a bit.
Well...
Oh, come on, it's easy. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. You're doing great.
Hello, I have been the caterer of these Jewish weddings for 16 years, and there's so much work.
Psst, psst, boss!
Excuse me, one of my staff seems to need me. What's up?
We're running out of wine, boss!
No problem. Open the extra jars we brought into the house.
Okay, sorry to bother you.
As I was saying, it's my job.
Boss! Hey, boss!
Now what do you need?
I just forgot that I already did that. The extra jars are empty too.
Then go out to the cart and bring those jars, the backup supply we brought.
Okay, I'm on it.
It's so hard to get good help these days.
Boss! Hey, boss!
Now what?
I forgot. I already did that too. Our backup has been used up.
So how much wine do we actually have left?
Well, if you include the jars we brought into the house first, plus our backup supply and the jar I left in the cart by accident, I guess that would be our backup supply, and you subtract what people have already drank, that leaves us with, let's see, nothing, not a drop. We're bone dry in there, boss.
But we can't run out of wine at a wedding feast. What will people say? What will people do?
Where's that caterer? I'm gonna throttle him!
That's the bride's father, and that's pretty much what he's gonna do.
We'll go and install them. I'll think of something.
Okay, but think fast.
This is awful. These wedding parties can go on for days and have lots to eat and drink as part of the celebration. When you run out of wine, it really embarrasses the person putting on the party. We're so sunk. I'll never get hired again if we don't do something, but what can I do? I only brought so much wine. I wonder what that was all about.
Boss, problem solved!
What happened? Were those people cheering you?
Not me. Jesus! He just did the most amazing thing! You should have seen it!
Is Jesus one of the guests here?
Yeah, he came with his mom and some friends.
And he brought wine?
No, he made wine. Out of water! He had some guys fill 6 stone jars with water. Then, when they dipped out the water, it was wine!
But that's not possible.
Maybe not, but it happened. Hear how happy those people are? That's because they saw something amazing. A miracle. And they're drinking the best wine they've ever tasted.
So you're telling me Jesus made wine out of water?
Yep.
And it's good wine?
The banquet master said it's even better than the wine we brought.
You think Jesus could do this any time he wanted? Turn water into wine?
I don't know. Maybe. What?
Think about it. Water is free, and good wine costs lots of money. If Jesus makes me wine for free and I sell it, I'll get rich. I have to go off for a job right now. He's inside?
Yeah. He was by the buffet table last time I looked, waiting in line for hummus.
Well, thanks again for coming. My assistant here can take care of getting you something to eat. I have to go interview someone I want to hire.
Bye. Okay, boss. Does anyone here like chocolate cake? Great! I'd get you some. But we ran out of that, too. That was vanilla. Hey, maybe Jesus does cake. I'll go check. You wait here. Nope. Sorry. Guess you're out of luck. Jesus doesn't do miracles to make money. They said he does miracles to help people and to help them believe. Well, I gotta go back to work. Bye.
Thank you. We hope you enjoyed the show. We are heavenly and holy, and we hope you enjoy the show.